A great start to the day.
I shouldn't be even vlogging right now. I need to be getting out of the house. So I set my alarm for 7:50. What I meant to do was set it for 7:20. I don't know what happened exactly last night when I was setting it for half an hour too late. So anyway, the alarm went off this morning and I was like, oh, it's fine. I have an hour before I have to leave. It's all good. And then after about 10 minutes of relaxation, I realised I actually didn't have very long to leave the house and have a shower and everything. So yeah, I've been doing that manically and oh, the whole thing's a mess. I've just been like pulling through various bags trying to find items and I haven't got time to tidy up. I haven't really got time to vlog. So we're actually going to have a rehearsal for I don't know, an hour and a half this morning before heading to the first gig. We've got two gigs today and it's in a festival again. Yeah, time is ticking. We can't really afford to be late. The drummer has got a puncture. She texted late last night while we were travelling back from yesterday's gig saying she needs a lift, so we're going earlier than we otherwise would to pick her up. Maybe this might be why I set my alarm for what I did, because I forgot about the diversion to pick the drummer up. So anyway, right, I've got to put the camera down now and get myself ready, get myself packed and out. I haven't had any breakfast, but I'll pack something, I think.
That's my breakfast, Bombay mix in the car. It's kind of semi-balanced. I mean, there's lentils in there. There's carbon protein anyway. Well, it's not okay. It's not that balanced. It's a bit balanced.
He hasn't had any breakfast, so he's just quickly run into a Greggs, which is right en route now, and he's going to get me a coffee. I said, I'll tell you what, I'll have a pasty, but I won't eat it now. I'll shove it in my bag so I can eat it in the car going from the rehearsal to the gig, because we will be very squeezed for time then. So that would be good preparation.
So he's in there, I'm just sitting in the car waiting for him. Got a whole bag of snacks packed there. They'll probably be living in the car, to be honest. When we've done our gigs,
we tend to be ravenous. Not for most of my gigs I do, but things like this, where I can be a bit nervous before, like the whole of the day, and I don't want to eat very much. But then after the gig, it's like this huge rush of relief that comes. And you get adrenaline on stage as well in this sort of situation. And then after that's worn off, the hunger kicks in and it's like a ravenous hunger. Like, we were so hungry yesterday after our gig. Oh, I ate so much. Anyway, I've had a light bit of Bombay mix for my breakfast and that'll hopefully keep me going. But I'll appreciate a coffee now anyway. I only had one before leaving the house and it was an old one as well. There was like some old coffee left in the pot from the day, not yesterday, but the day before. So like that, it wasn't the best, but I didn't have time to put a fresh pot on.
I haven't vlogged because we've been too busy, but this is where we've been practicing and we're just packing up and we're heading off. It's interesting walking up the corridor because you hear like different sounds coming from different rooms. If you've never seen a practice studio before, we tend to have like double doors, so it's really quite soundproof. So we couldn't hear them at all and they couldn't hear us. And when I went off to the loo, I was walking down the corridor and I couldn't hear anything of our band until I opened the door. Right, gotta pack up now then and get going quick. And we're off to the gig, aren't we? We've got a shuttle apparently.
It sounds like Star Trek, well who knows. We're boldly going where no band has been before. No, we're not really. We had this shuttle thing before and I remember it being very stressful and taking a lot longer than it was meant to. Well, I'm sure that we got there thinking, right, we've got to get to this stage at like one or whatever it was. And we arrived at the shuttle at one and then there was a massive, massive hold up and we ended up running with our heavy gear,
yeah,
being late, with the sound man just sitting there on his own waiting for us, something like that, because we hadn't realised about the shot, but we know now.
It might have just been the total fluky one off anyway. Oh, I stashed my pasty. Out comes the pasty.
I've got pasty envy now.
Oh, do you want a bite?
No, I
don't. Do you want to bite my pasty?
Good news is there's no shuttle. It's not complicated, we're just going to walk there and it's very close. The bad news is I've dropped the pasty on my lap halfway through eating it while I was trying to get that shot of the tunnel and pasty slime went on my dress and I tried to rub it off and actually rubbed it in. But anyway, never mind.
It's my GoPro.
Oh, that's cool.
It's nice, stable, steady shots on this one.
I've never seen
this. Yeah, if I'm on the move, I tend to use this one. Apparently it's going to be hot today. Somebody was telling me in Tesco's Pontypool the other day, so it's going to be 26 degrees. So let's see. We are here all day. We got two sets with a huge gap in between the two sets to just pass the time really. I hear jazz. That's a nice welcome. I don't know where I'm going. I'm just following Danny. He's there. So I'm just, don't lose sight of Danny, quick. He's going to get lost in the crowd. It's windy. us flute players do not like playing in the wind.
It's to do with the way the air comes out of the mouth and goes into the hole. It needs to be just so, and if a big gust of wind comes and disrupts it, oh, it's not good.
It's hard work it is. You've got to just continuously micro-adjust to keep your tone consistent, and then you can't just relax and enjoy the music, get into it, so concentrate in.
Well, now I've been out in the sunshine watching that other band that's on before us. They're ever so good. I'm really, really enjoying it. I'll try and get their name and put it on screen for you.
This is our little bandy bit where we're sheltered from the sun and all that. It's a very hot, sunny day, actually. It's cup of tea time. We've done our first set.
It went all right. Everyone's just kind of milling around, chilling out in the sunshine today. So, yeah, nice chilled one.
They have provided us with sandwiches.
This probably seems like a strange thing to be doing halfway through a gig, but we've got literally hours between now and the next set. So, you know, it being a scorching hot day with no shade really, much shade, we're going to IKEA because they have air conditioning, they have shade, they have an ice cream machine, cheap drinks and food, and they have a garlic press. Yeah, I think I want that garlic press. I don't know if they still have them. We'll find out today. I want one. I want one like yours because it's the best.
Well, I bought it because you had one.
So. Yeah, well, I had one and it eventually fatigued and broke from overuse, but I had it a long time before that happened, to be fair to it. IKEA. Look, we've come to IKEA. I've been here for ages, actually. There's that listed thing. It was a gas container, wasn't it? It used to go up and down in the olden days, but it's listed now, apparently.
Oh, these are nice, aren't they? They remind me a bit of the Chinese ones. Decided to get myself another one of these. I have got one, but it keeps getting ended up in another house, you know, because I'm kind of spread across two households in a way. I'm kind of semi-mystified by what this is for.
Well, you could check your rubbish in it.
Are they all tied together? They are all tied together. Hang on, there's a picture here. Wow, not quite sure. IB thinks it's for whisking your peel and your rinds and all that, ready to put in the compost. I wonder if it's like you shove your food in it and then you transfer it in that to the pan, because quite often I like grab it in my hands and put it in the pan or try and lift the chopping board and it's all a bit ungainly, but who knows? Still mooching around IKEA, we're just having a little look out of the window here and wondering what they're building out there. This is about the fourth attempt at this shot and now the speaker announcement's on. Right, hopefully fifth time lucky now without getting interrupted. IB is considering getting one of these because he has this tray already at home and he's suddenly thinking, oh, multi-story shoe rack, because he uses one of these already for his muddy footwear when he comes in and out. So he's actually got one. He's carrying it around. Bag muck. Oh, well, it does collect a bit of muck. It's lovely and peaceful and quiet in here at the moment. Quite the contrast from the hustle and bustle of Cardiff Bay and the hot sunshine. I always love the kids' bedrooms. I like the dens, but you know what? My daughter was never into dens. I loved dens and pretending I was camping and having my own little home, but she was just never into that, really. I bought this sort of thing for her and it just ended up being taken back off again because she wasn't into it. Look at the shark mouth. Tea party, anyone? Now that is the bed that I wanted for my daughter. I so wanted it, but it was just too high for our lower ceiling, so she never had it. I grieve that to this day. Look at all that desk space underneath. And now she's on the brink of leaving home. How time flies. We have come to the kitchen section. I'm on the lookout for... Oh, Ivy's on the lookout for my garlic press. That's the one!
Well,
that's
bigger, the one!
How much is that? Oh, it's the same size.
£4.
That is the same size. That is the same size as yours.
It's not the same size as mine. Mine is smaller than that.
Well, tell you what...
I'm always having trouble getting the garlic out.
I'll tell you what, we'll have a look later and we'll see. £4. Oh, I'm so happy. Yes!
I would possibly buy myself another spoon rest if I saw one. You see, I resisted getting a spoon rest for years because I thought, well, just use a plate, just use a little plate. Why take up more, you know, room in your kitchen with an extra item that you don't really need? But since I finally caved in and bought one, when it's in the dishwasher, ready to be washed, I miss that spoon rest. I tell you what, so I could have one for, you know, or I could just wash it. I could just wash it. That would be more sensible.
I'm really good at talking myself out of purchases. They have napkins in holders. Ooh, like a tissue box, but for napkins. I like these little mini mugs, you know, but look, they don't have handles. But they're so cute. And they actually come in packs of four, and they're £12 for four. The problem with me is I like big amounts of drink. That would be too small for me. Oh, I've seen these V-shaped pillows before. I fancy getting one of these. And you know what? My subscribers in the past have recommended them, actually. I think specifically from Asda, that one. But they have them here in IKEA too. They're £15. I don't know if I'm going to get anything like that today. I don't know. Just, well, I suppose I could, couldn't I? Oh, and there's the pillowcase to go with it. Look, £5 for the pillowcase. So £20 all in. I am tempted, I must say. I'll leave it for now and think on.
But on the occasions where I've kind of made a V-shape out of my two normal pillows, I have found it quite comfy and snuggly and cosy, actually. And it's kind of made me feel extra relaxed and then made me fall asleep a bit quicker. Sometimes, anyway. Sometimes I'm not in the mood for it. I don't know. It just depends.
I'm just at the till about to pay, and I was looking at these shoe organisers. I was thinking, is that a footrest for a classical guitarist? They're a bit flimsy. Oh, no, not too bad. If Izzy was still learning guitar and in need of a footrest, I'd probably get her that for that reason.
Ah, this is the life. So we've worked up a little bit of an appetite now, and we've stopped in the snack bar bit.
I've got myself a vegan hot dog. I'm going to put some sauce on it now. It does come with trimmings, but I'm not very keen on it. We've got
tokens for an ice cream each. I'm going to go for a vegan. He's going to go for a dairy. And a soft drink cup.
There we are, mustard and ketchup, and I forgot about the fries, they're lovely and hot and fresh. We saw them putting them in, actually. Wow, it's a vegan soft serve time for me. Right now, let's have a taste. Yep, very pleasant.
We are having a very bizarre day with this great big gap between the gigs. So he was falling asleep whilst eating his hot dog practically. So I said, look, do you want to kip in the car? Because he loves to sleep in his car. He likes little power naps. So he's sleeping in the car. So I'm going to do some language learning. I can't quite decide whether to do some Duolingo or have a quick walk. I've got my pop left over here from the doodah. And so I'm not quite sure what I'm doing, but might go for a walk. We're here for half hour anyway. I decided I would have a little bit of a walk, and there's nobody here. I used to walk this route quite a lot once. My daughter used to do a drama group near here when I was home educating, so I know this path well.
You can walk on foot, you know, from IKEA all the way up here to the end of Penarth Road, actually.
I had to go for a walk to warm up because there was such a breeze blowing through that undercover car park. I was freezing. And we're off back down to the bay for our second shift. Feels like a repeat of this morning when I was filming going to the site. Ugh, but I tell you what, I got less energy this time than I did this morning. I was full of beans and yes, I was a lot livelier this morning than I am now. I'm feeling a bit sleepy. Now the evening, and we finished our second and final set for the day and heading back to the car park. Oh, I'm tired, and I tell you what, my legs are aching.
My feet and my legs are aching, and I think it might be because I've got these daps on, and I normally wear like more mountain booty, what's it called, walking booty type things with a lot more spring in them, and I think that's why. Yeah.
Can I just say it's been a long flipping day?
It's a funny thing just hanging around. We had this yesterday, hours and hours of hanging around. You're not really doing anything, but somehow it makes you tired. I don't know, maybe it's just information overload with so much stuff going on. You can't really fully relax as if you were in your own home on your own sofa. So I don't know. Strange. I haven't done these sorts of gigs for a while, really. I've been mainly doing weddings when we just turn up, set up, gig, pack down, go home, rather than hours and hours and hours of waiting somewhere outside, you know. But anyway, successfully done, finished, job done. We got another gig tomorrow. I think this evening, me and my boyfriend are going to go and have a pint in the pub.
So it's back to the car now.
It's about 20 past eight now. We've literally just got back in through the door to my boyfriend's house. We are shattered. Oh my goodness. Anyway, we got through it. People danced, people clapped, people were merry, enjoying life generally. So it was all fine. We got another gig tomorrow, but no depths. Like nobody that we haven't played with before for that one. So we're going to get a bit of a shower now because we've been out in the sun all day. And then we're going to go to the pub to relax this evening. But thank you so much for watching today's video. Please give it a like if you happen to like it. Subscribe down below to watch more videos from me, and I'll see you in the next video. Have I got sunburn? I think I might have got sunburn today. Oops. Oh. It's the funny end to the... I ended up in full sun in the last set. I thought we were going to be shaded, and I wasn't. Yeah, anyway, right. See ya. Bye.